Last video, we learned a lot of ways to define variables in our program's data section. Now, let's use this process to create our first program, Hello World. The goal of this program is to print Hello World to the console and then exit the program gracefully. Exiting gracefully just means exiting intentionally, preventing the program from reading data as code that isn't meant to be read. We start by creating our data section, defining a label that has the value of the address where the first character in the string Hello World is located. We use DB because each character is the size of a byte. The next section is the text section, which is where the actual code goes. We start by telling the program to start at the start label. You don't need to know how that works for now. Then, we have to utilize built-in actions that Linux has created for us. These are called syscalls. To use a syscall, you first move the value of the syscall you intend to call into the RAX register. For us, this is 1, which is the write syscall. Next, you pass each parameter that the syscall expects into the expected registers. The first argument goes into register RDI, the second into RSI, then RDX, then R10, then R8, and finally R9. The write syscall expects 3 arguments in this order: the file descriptor, the address of the first character in the string, and the length of the string. We pass each of these values into RDI, RSI, and RDX. The file descriptor for the terminal is 1. We get the address from the label called MSG, and we can count that there are 13 characters in the string. Finally, we write syscall to tell Linux to perform the syscall using the values that we set. Next, we will use syscall number 60, which exits the program. The exit syscall takes in an argument, which is the error code. The error code is useful for debugging because after a program runs, if it fails, you can tell why by reading the error code. An error code of 0 means the program ran successfully, so we will set RDI to 0. Again, we write syscall to tell Linux to perform the syscall using the values that we set.